Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about a third topic, that is the cell cycle. So already we have discussed about the anatomy and physiology introduction and what is the cell, what is the structure, shape, organelles of the cell, etc. Today we are going to discuss how the cell is going to divide, what is the process of cell division, and how the cell is dividing by what process, what are the two types of processes. So we are going to discuss in detail about that. So let's go into the topic. And introduction. Many damaged, dead and worn out cells can be replaced by the growth and division of other similar cells. This allows the effective maintenance of the body tissues. So for the bodies to work properly, functionally, cell is the main important thing. If a cell is being damaged, dead or worn out, anything can be happened. So it should be replaced by a new cell. So how it is can be replaced by the other similar cells? If a muscle cell is being damaged, the same muscle cell, it is growing and it is being divided and it is replacing the damaged, dead and the worn out cell. So cell with nuclei have 46 chromosomes and divide by mitosis, the process that result in two new genetically identical daughter cells. So if a cell is having a nuclei, it is automatically having 46 chromosome in it, and the 46 chromosome cell is being divided by the process called mitosis. In this process, what is the end result is two new genetically identical daughter cells. If a cell is having 46 chromosome, that cell which is being end result, that is the two new identical daughter cells, both the cells, each one is having 46 cells. This is the division process, and the process name is called the mitosis. The only exception to this is the formation of gametes, that is the sex cell, that is the ova and spermatozoa, which takes place by meiosis. So all the cells in the body which is being divided by mitosis except the sex cells. What are the sex cells? That is the ova in female and spermatozoa in male, which only takes place by meiosis. This is the main difference between mitosis and meiosis. So the period between two cell division is known as the cell cycle. So one cell is being divided and it takes a complete cycle, that is a cell cycle, to for the cell to divide again. So that process is called as the cell cycle, which has two phases that can be seen by light microscopy. So only through light microscopy the cell cycle can be seen, and there are two phases, that is the mitosis M phase and interphase. So these are the two phases. We will first see about the interphase. So this is the cell cycle, the complete cell cycle. So this is the in blue one, which is called as the interphase. It has three stages, that is the growth, G1 is DNA replicates, G2 growth preparation for cell division. So if you remember this diagram, you can easily write about all the topics. And next one is the green one is called as the mitosis, that is the M phase, and cytokinesis. These two comprises the M phase. So first we'll see about the phase. This is the longest phase, and three different stages are recognized. This interphase is the longest phase because three stages are being there. So it is the longest phase. The first gap phase, G1, the cell grow in size and volume. In this G1, it is growing in size and volume. So that's why it is able to divide. So this is the G1. This is usually the longest phase and most variable in length. So this interphase is the longest phase because three stages have to be taken up. So that if a cell is being divided in 5 days, another cell cannot be divided in the same 5 days because it depends upon the cell. So how long it takes, it depends upon the interphase. Sometimes cell do not continue round the cell cycle but entering the resting phase G0. So sometimes cell enters, cell cannot divide properly, it is starting to divide but it is entering the resting phase, that is called as a G0, and it is being checked out here. Otherwise it completes the DNA replication, everything, and coming for the G2, that is the growth preparation for cell division. At this point is not able to divide and it's being damaged and it's being getting out. So otherwise it is in completing this mitosis process and can be checked. So whatever stage it is going on, it is entering the phase called resting phase, that is called as the G0. During this time, cells carry their specific function, that is the secretion and absorption. So whatever process is being going inside the cell, it doesn't matter. The cell will be performing its function, example secretion or absorption, whatever may be it, the cell will be performing that function. So the interphase, the first phase being completed, G1, and next is the S phase. The chromosome replicate, forming two identical copies of DNA. Therefore, following the S phase, the cell now has 92 chromosomes, that is enough DNA for the cell, and is nearly ready to divide by mitosis. So the cell is being going to divide. So 46 plus 46, that is a 92, here 46 and here 46, totally 92 chromosomes being formed in this S phase, synthesis of DNA, this being taking place in this process of S phase. So next is the G2, that is the second gap phase. G1 is the first gap phase, G2 is the second gap phase. There is further growth and preparation for cell division. So the cell is being grown further and the preparing it for cell division. So next is the process of mitosis. So this is a continuous process involving four distinct stages visible by light microscopy, and only through light microscopy we can see this. There are four distinct stages in this mitosis. That are the first one is the prophase, second one is metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So four different stages are being present. The first one is the prophase. Each of the original 46 chromosome called the chromatid at this stage is paired with its copy in a double chromosome unit. So we told that one is having 46 and another one is having 46. Both the 46 are being joined together and they are being paired as 92 chromosome. They are, so we should not call it chromosome at this stage, because they are chromatid at this stage. Okay, we should call them as chromatid. So the two chromatids joined together each other at the centromere. So you can see here at this stage, these two chromatids are joined together here, where they are forming the 92 chromosome being joined together here. Okay. So the mitotic apparatus appears. This consists of two centrioles. Next is the mitotic apparatus. Okay. This is the mitotic apparatus. It appears, which consists of two centrioles, is being present here. So separated by mitotic spindle, which is formed from microtubules. So from where this mitotic spindle or mitotic apparatus is being appeared in a cell, we have seen in the cell structure as the microtubules. This microtubules, which is being formed as mitotic spindle. So in our home and all, we have seen this thread which is being tied, and it is called as a spindle. So in earlier days, it is called as the spindle, a big thread which is being tied. So the shape of this microtubules is like a spindle. So it is called as the mitotic spindle. Okay. The centriole migrate one to each end of the cell, and the nuclear envelope develops. So what happens, it start forming the nuclear envelope at this prophase. So next stage you can clearly see that. So here the nuclear envelope, it start forming here. So in metaphase, the chromatids align at the center of the spindle attached to the centromere. The centromere is here. This is the microtubules, that's the mitotic spindle. We should not call this microtubules, it is called the mitotic spindle. And this is called as the chromatid. At this stage, we should call this the chromatid, because 92 chromatids, they are being joined together and they are being aligned at the center of the spindle. I told you, no, we call this shape as a spindle shape. Okay. This shape as a spindle shape. So this is they are lying at the center of the spindle. So in anaphase, the centromeres separate, and one of each pair of the sister chromatid, now called as chromosome again because they are divided, so they are called the chromosome again, migrate to each end of the spindle as microtubules that form the mitotic spindle contract. So we told this as the chromatid, mitotic spindle. No, now it is again called as the microtubules, because it is being separated, and this chromatid is being separated, and it is again called as chromosome again, and this centromeres are being separated. Everything is being separated at this anaphase. So in telophase, the mitotic spindle disappears, the chromosome uncoil, and the nuclear envelope reforms. So in this stage, you can see this yellow color, that the microtubules, this is being disappearing, and this blue color chromosomes are being joined together and the nuclear envelope forms, and this centromere, it is being separated from each other. So that is the telophase, you can see here. Okay. So last one is the cytokinesis. Following telophase, cytokinesis occur, the cytosol, intracellular organelles and the plasma membrane split, forming two identical daughter cells. So now they are forming two identical daughter cells, and the plasma membrane, everything, whatever a cell is needed, whatever the organelles of the cell, it is being formed, and you can see contractile ring creating a cleavage for a furrow, a split is being formed, and two identical daughter cells is being formed. So here you can see, if following this only telophase only, the cytokines is occurring. So here a cut is being taking place, and it is forming into a new cell of with 46 chromosome, and this one again with the new chromosome of 46 chromosome. So this is the process of cell cycle. So let us conclude this. Okay, let us conclude this. There are two phases mainly, interphase and the M phase. The M phase consists of the mitosis and the cytokinesis, that is the M phase. So in G1, the growth is happening, it is increasing in size and volume. In S phase, that is the DNA is replicating and it is forming into 92 chromosomes, that is the chromatids it's forming. In G2, the growth preparation, and it's again it's growing and it is preparing it for cell division. So mitosis, there are four processes: prophase, metaphase, anaphase and the telophase. And last one is the cytokinesis, where it is being forming into a two identical daughter cell. So this is the complete process of the cell cycle. So thank you everyone for watching my video. So if you have any suggestions or anything, you could just post it in your comment section below. And I'm posting the same video which I'm making in English and also Tamil. So if you want, you can refer to that. And only the slides, if you want to review the slides, only the slides, you can go visit my nursing abstract blog site, and then you can visit that. Only the slides. So in next further classes, we can detailly describe more about how the cell is being transported, everything. So thank you so much.